surprised me. I think flavours is a really underestimated experience with regards to hearing, seeing, smelling, tasting. Tasting is a wonderful thing to me. I wanna
hold you so much. It's slightly sort of aspirational, isn't it? You know, you want to buy olive oil with a bit of a basil leaf inside it, because that means you've made it, doesn't it?
Basically, you can go into a supermarket and really get practically anything you want to buy from any time of the year. The pace of life now is so fast, you can just get everything. But if you feel like I feel, please let me know that it's real.
You're just too good to be true. A lot of the things that we buy represent ourselves. We're trying to buy pictures of ourselves, if you like, so that people are no longer buying products, they're buying experiences.
The might of the supermarket is now felt in even the sleepiest corners of the globe, as well as the darkest recesses of our subconscious. Here in southern Portugal, they await the fruit man from Waitrose, who really can say yes. Richard Hind is on a mission that could transform the local economy by convincing us to buy something we never knew we even wanted.
Fruit is today's lifestyle. It's healthy, it's vibrant, colourful, and if we look at exotic fruits, there's all of those in one. Fantastic colours, fantastic taste, exquisite locations. What we try to do is to give our customers, well, we try to delight them. We try to find the fruits and the vegetables that they may have seen on their travels, and bring those foods to their table.
Maybe even two exotic or one exotic plus.
And this, for Richard, is where he'll find the proof of the pudding. Can he convince the middle-class dinner party set that life is not complete without the glamour of the latest exotic fruit?
And let's taste it, and if it tastes all right, we'll...
Let's see what we find when we go on.
And if it doesn't taste right, we'll add booze to it.
Okay.
Yeah?
Yeah.
All right, then.
So Richard scours the world for what he hopes will be the latest fruity fashion statement. What juicy secrets can he discover in Portugal?
Fantastic. Just what I want.
Hey, Danny, I've just found some fantastic Rocco Brianti. Where are we, do you know? When are we going to add them? Or have we done that already?
Muscat Italia cedar grapes, got that for a bunch. Fantastic.
Excuse it. See? What about grapes? What about the South African grapes? Because that was 2 weeks late. Any ideas? Merci, merci beaucoup.
Muito obrigada.
Muito obrigada.
Muito obrigada.
Muito obrigada.
But what Richard's really come for is this, the Kiwano horned melon. Here, he believes, is what the fruit bowls of the home counties have been waiting for. The challenge is in convincing shoppers to buy them when they haven't a clue what they taste like.
It's unusual. It's vivid orange, reddish stripes, very prickly, and it looks stunning on the shelves.
Okay, let's find the exotic fruits. Look at these, kiwanos. Should we try those?
Why not? We can mix them with some other.
Every time I go into Waitrose, there's a new fruit that I've... Well, what's this one? Weird shape, you know. But I'll try it. Other people will try it. It's getting you to spend your money, isn't it? That's what it's all about.
Thanks to the supermarkets, the simple act of preparing a meal can now be as much about fad as flavour.
Oh, God, I haven't made a bloody coffee.
So has Richard discovered the latest in fruity chic? Will the discerning Waitrose shopper be hooked on the horns of the Kiwano?
Hey, the horn melon, the kiwana. Is that going to be the food of 2001 that the kiwi fruit was in the 80s.
I think they're beautiful looking fruits.
Oh, they're
really lovely in colour. Yeah.
It would look lovely in a fruit bowl, but you'd never eat it. I mean, it's sort of keeping up with the Joneses. Oh, I've got my kiwano there. I wonder if they'll have one there next week.
Hmm, do you think?
It makes kiwi fruit sensational.
It actually does. There's no flavour to it, though.
That's a good way of putting
it. There isn't very much flavour to it, is there?
I think it looks great.
But it's a great look.
It looks pretty.
I still need to do something with
flavor.
It.
You know, that's what a kiwano's for. I mean, decorating a room, maybe. Lawrence Llewellyn and Bowen have great fun with a kiwano.
I'm no less than a supermarket. I can no longer shop happily. I came in here for a special advert. Guaranteed personality.
The British shopper is besotted by supermarkets. We glide down their aisles so wedded to the convenience and choice that we'd find it hard to survive life without them. Today, three quarters of all the food we eat is bought from the five big supermarket chains. This is the story of the supermarket's rise to power and the lives they've changed on the way. Years ago, most British shoppers had never been in a supermarket.
There is a co-op in the town.
Those who promoted American-style self-service stores were often dismissed as basket cases, but the retail revolution was to prove unstoppable.
If advocates believe that when the customers see more, they'll want more. And the self-service store exploits that to the full.
I remember when I was about 10, the first supermarket opened where I lived, and it was the co-op. And so suddenly you had this facility of walking around with a basket, and I just always remember it. It was like it was the first sort of self-service shop I'd ever been into, and it was really exciting.
We no longer shopped for what we needed, but what we wanted. Impulse buying had been born. One man was about to push it for all it was worth. Jack Cohen, founder of the Tesco empire.
When I first started with the company, I viewed him as obviously he appeared to be the owner of the company, but he appeared to be a bit of a crook, a nice one, and one that you could feel quite affectionate about. But nevertheless, he was not playing everything strictly by the book.
Jack Cohen's philosophy was pile it high, sell it cheap.
All my work has only been by instinct, by having a feel that this is the right thing to do. Take a chance, you know, give a man a chance to make a living, give him a decent wage and let him prove himself.
The former Barrow boy built his supermarket dynasty with one thing in mind, profit.
All the profits going bang. No way it happens, you know.
Profit only. Jack Cohen, that's all he ever thought of was profit.
As Tesco grew, so did Slasher Jack's millions. He was the working class housewife's hero who rewrote the retail rule book as he amassed his fortune.
He was in the market to buy anything from anywhere. And if he thought he could sell it and make a bit of a margin, that's what he would do.
Jack would go to almost any lengths to do just that.
A cargo boat sank on the Goodwin Sands, and it was full of flying bird cream. And he bought the whole consignment. And, of course, by the time we got it into the warehouses, the tins were a bit rusty. So they were sent off to the shops with a little note to the managers saying, This is a flying bird cream, and the tins are a bit rusty, but use some Duraglit to sort of clean them up and sell them.
As Tesco's power grew, so did its fearsome reputation for turning the screws on its suppliers.
What is the price?
Well, for a special price, if you do it on a promotion, I could get down to 14 shillings a dozen, sieve.